Now we will solve this question. This is one of the most important questions. Find by double integration the area common to this circle and y square equal to 9x parabola. Okay, so here we will be using this formula. For your information, I have written down this formula. So now, to draw the region of integration, x square plus y square equal to 10 is a circle with center 0, 0 and radius root of 10. Okay, so I have drawn the circle here and y square equal to 9x is a parabola symmetrical to the x axis, y square equal to 9x. So here you are asked to find the area common to circle and the parabola, means this is the region of integration, or this is the region of which we need to find the area. Okay, so here now we will solve this question. Then, so this is 0, 0 and this is a circle, x square plus y square is 10 and this is y square equal to 9x. So area is equal to double integral over dx dy. Okay, now since I have taken here dx dy, draw a strip parallel to the x axis. So now depending on the movement of this strip, you can find the limits for x and y. So when this strip parallels to x axis, its left part, this part gives you the lower limit of x. Okay, so lower limit of x means this is y square is 9x, so x will be y square upon 9. So that will be the lower limit of x, y square by 9, and upper limit, to get the upper limit, this strip, this end will give the upper limit. So this is which circle? X square plus y square equal to 10. So x square plus y square equal to 10, there x square is equal to 10 minus y square, or x is under root of 10 minus y square. So that is under root of 10 minus y square. Okay, then that is the value of x. Then now to get the limit for y, now from where to where the y goes, so y moves from this part to this part, so you need to get the coordinates for these two. Okay, now to get the coordinates for these two points, you need to solve this. So x square means, suppose this is, I'm putting O and this is A, say B, C. I want to get the coordinates for this A and C to know the limit for y. Okay, then x square, so this is the point of intersection of the parabola and the circle, both. So x square plus y square equal to 10 is the circle, y square equal to 9x is the parabola. Now solve this together, that means here I will put x square plus y square is 9x, so I'll put that 9x here, 9x equal to 10, that means x square plus 9x, take this 10 to left side, minus 10 equal to 0. Solving this, you will get x equal to 1 and minus 10. So here x equal to minus 10 we won't take, because if you take minus 10, y square will be minus 90 and y will be under root of minus 90. So here our point of consideration is not a complex number, it's a real number, so we do not take this one. Okay, so x is equal to 1. When x is 1, y square is 9. So y is equal to plus or minus 3 you will get. Then, so 1 point means here this positive point, this is in the positive part. So this will be 1 plus 3 and this will be obviously 1 minus 3. Because being in the this part, it will be y is negative here. Then, so y goes from where to where? So that strip is, suppose the strip sweeps to this place, so here when it reaches here, the value of y is minus 3, negative 3, and when it moves up and touches here, y is positive 3. So y goes from negative 3 to positive 3. Now we need to integrate this. So that is equal to negative 3 minus 3 to plus 3, integral of dx is x, limit y square by 9 to under root of 10 minus y square dy. Now integrate this. This is equal to negative 3 to positive 3, upper limit is root of 10 minus y square minus lower limit y square by 9 dy. Okay, now this is equal to, now again term by term integration, under root of 10 minus y square is of this form, root of a square minus x square form. So there a square is 10 and instead of x here we have y. Therefore by that formula it is y divided by 2 under root of 10 minus y square plus a square by 2 means 10 by 2 sine inverse y divided by root of 10 y by a. So by root of 10 minus 3 to plus 3 minus here y square by 9, integral of y square is y cube divided by 3 and this 9. So 9 threes are 27, again limit minus 3 to plus 3. So this is equal to, now again even without doing this negative 3 to positive 3, instead of this you can write this as 2 times 0 to 3. That is also another method. It is 2 times because here up and down both the areas will be same. So instead of doing this minus 3 to plus 3, you can write it as 2 times 0 to 3. 2 times 0 to 3 and integral of this. Okay, so that also.